Never has there been a more fitting name for a team than the Blues. Failure runs deep in their veins, and what better way to celebrate than by rubbing salt on the wounds? You actually make the Stanley Cup Finals in your first year of existence. Sure, you're in a conference with all the other expansion teams and you're projected to get destroyed, but it's still admirable. Maybe you can shock the world. Unfortunately, reality sets in and you're swept by the Canadiens. Rebound and make the finals again next year. Your team is even stronger now, so you have a fighting chance. Wash, rinse, repeat. Alright, 3 straight years in the final. Let's hope you can actually win a game. You get swept by the Bruins. Yeah, that goal. You also lose in the first round to Minnesota. Head coach Scotty Bowman has a schism with ownership and he chooses to fuck off. Get completely steamrolled by the Bruins. Deja vu, ain't it? It's now the Blackhawks' turn to kick your ass. Hope you guys like coaching carousels. Meddlesome ownership will do that to you. Enjoy something that you will come to know like the back of your hand. First round playoff losses. Get dominated by the Canadiens in the second round. Turns out Scotty Bowman did pretty well for himself in Montreal. Welcome to the penny-pinching hell that is ownership under the Ralston Purina Company. You are terrible. Completely and objectively terrible. Enjoy the basement, Blues fans. Emerge from the doldrums at the turn of the decade. And get swept by the Blackhawks again. The best regular season you've ever had. It does not save you from losing in the second round. In fact, get eliminated by the Blackhawks again. And again. Your former coach, Al Arbor, he may have a cup or two in his cupboard. Congratulations! You get to move to the greener pastures of Saskatoon?
2 hours later.
Never mind, the NHL has come to their senses and are forcing you to stay in St. Louis. Enjoy the stress of having the team potentially contract as a reward. Have things get so bad that the owners padlock the arena and the Blues don't even participate in the draft. Strip everything clean to the point where the NHL tells Ralston Purina to fuck off. Fortunately, they find a new owner and the franchise is saved. One catch. He's avaricious as well. Reward your fanbase's patience with a gut-wrenching loss to the North Stars in an overtime game 7. Heal these wounds by getting swept by that team the very next year. You make the conference finals again. You've reached game 7. You could get back to the finals. Or get dick-punched by the Flames. Ouch. Lose in the first round again, this time to the fucking Maple Leafs. The good news is that you actually beat the Blackhawks in a series. The bad news is that you get smacked around by the Red Wings the next round. Go back in time to the early 80s and get eliminated by the Blackhawks in the second round. Don't look now, a bunch of your old players just won a cup with the Flames. At least you got Brett Hull from one of those trades. Enjoy the Blackhawk pain again, this time getting obliterated by them in Game 7. Another outstanding regular season, another elimination in the second round. Once again, to the North Stars. Sign Brendan Shanahan as a restricted free agent. The price isn't too steep, you only have to give Scott Stevens to the Devils. In fact, get bested by those fucking Blackhawks again. You get revenge on the Blackhawks. Glorious victories are soon to be yours. By whimpering quietly in Game 7 to the Maple Leafs. Shed that painful loss, only to get swept by the Stars. Mike Keenan is now your head coach and GM. This means that you've got about a year and a half before his shtick becomes toxic. He leads you to a 7-game loss to the Canucks in the first round. Meanwhile, Scott Stevens just won himself his first cup. Alright, you're going all in this year. Keenan has all but cloned the 94 Rangers formula of 80s Oilers and early 90s Blackhawks players. He may have gutted the team he started with, but you got the fucking great one at the deadline to help complement the Golden Brett. Now go and get that cup.
Second overtime. Gretzky had it, lost it. Eisenman picks it up. Eisenman moving. Blue line chance. Stevenson!
I forgot to ask, how's that Gretzky trade working out? He signed with the Rangers because of management, you say. Turns out Mike Keenan was cancer incarnate. Who saw that one coming? Last year was brutal for you guys. You get consolation, though. Losing to the Red Wings again. Last year was brutal for you guys. You get consolation, though. losing to the Red Wings again. Did I mention Brendan Shanahan won some cups with them? You crushed the hopes and dreams of the Coyotes in an overtime Game 7. Maybe this is the year you go places. Or lose in 6 to the goddamn Stars again. Oh look, your old star Brett Hull won a cup with them too. You're going places now. You're the President's Trophy winner with elite goaltending Joel Quenneville, Norris winner Chris Pronger, and Pavel Dimitra. This is truly the year that you fall to the Sharks in the first round. For fuck's sake.
You blew it!
Alright, you made the third round for the first time in 15 years. You took out those pesky Sharks and the Stars. Do you get the monkey off your back? Hell no, you get battered in 5 to the Avalanche. Oh look, you get to lose to the Red Wings again. You're up 3-1 against the Canucks. To no one's surprise, you completely take the piss. The team is choking on their own shit enough that Joel Quenneville is told to get fucked. It doesn't matter because you still get your heads crushed by the Sharks. Owner Bill Lowry really wanted an NBA team in St. Louis. The Blues are losing him money because reasons. Sell fucking everything. Return to the basement with Mike Kitchen. Your postseason streak is over with only 2 appearances in the conference finals during this time. Woof. Rod Brind'Amour, Doug Weight, and Chris Pronger win cups in the interim. You made the playoffs again. You get swept by the Canucks. It's like you were never there. Miss the playoffs the next 2 years in the meantime. You're telling me that Joel Quenneville won a cup too? Things are on the right track with Ken Hitchcock. The Blues have the second best record in the NHL and they win a playoff series for the first time in 10 years. In Blues fashion, they fail and get swept by the Kings in the next round. You know what? You didn't go full Blues enough. You lose to the Kings in the first round this time. You have another great regular season. You already know how this story plays out. You're the goddamn second seed in the Western Conference and your favorites for the Cup. Please at least do something. You lose in 6 to the fucking Wild? Are you shitting me? Ugh, you're blowing a 3-1 series lead to the Blackhawks? Just get it over with so I can get the liquor. Wait, the Blues didn't fail? They're playing in the conference finals against the Sharks of all teams? By the gods, someone is shedding their choker label this year! Unfortunately, it's not you. Ken Hitchcock is retiring at the end of the year, so let's hire his replacement, Mike Yeo, as an assistant. This isn't awkward at all. The Blues are playing like bird shit right now. Fuck it, Snorlax is gone. Turns out that was the spark to get the team back on track. Jake Allen is playing like a god and they stole the series against the Wild. Maybe this is the year. Or they can lose in 6 to the Predators. One can only tolerate so much failure. Let's take a look at the final scores. This rate the man's well moved to Saskatoon.
Now it comes free, a chance here for Berglund to put it out in front, but it's knocked away by the Hawks. They try to break with numbers. Patrick Kane up the far side. Saad going to the net. Here Kane with a shot. He scores!